and the home of the Ms. International competition. Good evening, everyone. I'm Don Crickey. Every year now, the top women bodybuilders from around the world congregate here in Columbus, Ohio, for this standout competition with Arnold Schwarzenegger as its founding father. We're joined now by the man who is the number one box office attraction in the world, who hasn't forgot his roots, and that's in bodybuilding. I know you're delighted, Arnold, to see the women now taking part in a big way.
I am extremely excited to be here again. This is the seventh time that we run the Miss International competition. Now, of course, was a big supporter of women bodybuilding from day one. We now have over 100 countries that are competing, where women are competing in bodybuilding competitions, and it's great now. It all leads up to the Miss International competition.
We're going to be watching some of the best women. You know, they talk about femininity and people maybe look down on women in bodybuilding, but this is really a very hard-edged sport. These are top competitors we're going to be watching.
It's really a fantastic sport, and those women are really doing a great job. They're training hard 4 or 5 hours a day like the guys do, and they're really in terrific shape. And, of course, I always feel that their performance is even more exciting than the man's performance.
The competition consists of 4 rounds, standing relaxed, compulsory poses, free pose, and the pose down. At the conclusion of round 2, the women athletes are ranked, and the field is pared down to 10 finalists for round 3, the free pose. And that's what we'll begin with. Now, from New Jersey, this is 26-year-old Laura Bass, who's been moving up in the rankings.
Laura weighs 155 pounds.
Kicking into another gear here, Arnold.
Exactly. I think it's a very smart thing to do, because if you have the time and if you have a good routine, you should do that, because to show, you know, both sides, to show really a very kind of a ballet-like performance, but then again go into the dancing kind of a performance. She's very athletic, as you can see. The other thing that is very important in this competition is what kind of a bathing suit that you wear.
Laura Bass from Roselle Park, New Jersey, and she gets a tremendous ovation. With Arnold Schwarzenegger, this is Don Crickey back at the Ms. International competition in Columbus, Ohio. And our second competitor tonight, from Dallas, Texas, Vicky Gates.
There you will see, Don, how interesting it is, the different kind of music that each one of the competitors selects. And it is all, then the whole posing routine is designed around that music, because each competitor has a different type of a posing routine. Some are fast, some are slower, some are in a medium kind of rhythm. She chose to come in with a very slow rhythm, very slow. And now she speeds up to show to the judges again, both to show the slow posing and the hard flexing, and then tries to do a little bit of few sexy moves and very athletic moves.
Vicky choreographs her own routine. She actually was a very good track athlete at Oklahoma State and began in bodybuilding just to get stronger to become better in that sport, track and field.
A lot of these bodybuilders, men and women, all start for a different reason. A lot of them start, you know, to improve in another sport. And then all of a sudden they get hooked on it and they see they have a lot of potential in this in bodybuilding. And then they really drop the other sport almost and then get full time into the bodybuilding.
It's interesting, Arnold, the different competitors have very different training routines. Each of her sessions, each of Vicky Gates, lasts about 1.5 hours. She trains 5 days a week, although building up to a major competition like this, she might be in the gym a little longer.
Well, she has been training for 10 years, and she has been competing for almost 10 years. And She has worked her way up to a body weight of 140 pounds. And may I remind you, there's almost no fat there at all. I mean, it's just incredible. So you can really see the time and the effort that went in there. But there's some bodybuilders that, that really go on each set and on each exercise to the maximum. Bodybuilders train less hours, and there's others that train more hours and don't go to the maximum. So everyone has a different training principle.
Vicky Gates.
Vicky Gates. Here you can see how well proportioned the back is, the trapezius, the front side, and the rear deltoid. Everything is really well developed. I think this, she's going to score high.
And what a great setting. Arnold, the staging, the lighting, better than ever, as are the competitors.
It's really spectacular. I think the stage setting and the whole thing is really great, and we are working on it every year, so I think eventually we will get it right.
I think you've gotten it right. And there's a young lady, Astrid Falcone, who was born in Munich, Germany, now trains and competes out of Toronto, Canada. A recent middleweight Canadian champion, and she has also been judged to be the overall Canadian champion, Astrid Falcone.
She's been training now for 7 years, and I think she's doing an outstanding job, because I've seen her over the years grow and improve, and she has really come in her best shape. You can see the musculature on her back. I mean, every single muscle has been developed, also the front, and this is why she poses the way she does, to really show to the judges that, you know, her entire body is well developed and her symmetry is great, and now she's trying to really get the scores up there through her performance.
At Veterans Memorial Auditorium here in Columbus is packed.
Yeah, we have over 4,000 spectators. We have been sold out for 3 weeks, so it's a really it's the most popular event in the world now.
You were talking about development of her back. A lot of the competitors, both men and women, feel that's one of the tough areas to develop.
It is a very tough part to develop, but I think that if you do your rowing exercises and your chin-ups like she has done, then you will develop a good back. Here you can see the great separation of the biceps and the triceps and the brachialis and the definition around the stomach and the intercostals and the serratus muscles and all this stuff. I mean, it's really fantastic.
Now we come to Katie Rubas from Budapest, Hungary, who has twice been the overall Hungarian champion. She trains at the Coco Gym in Budapest, Hungary, as we've now gone to the Middle European countries, which are turning out top competitors in women's bodybuilding.
Hungary has actually a great bodybuilding champions, and not only for males, but females also. But this one has been training now for 5 years, competing for 3 years. And she's 5'5 tall. She weighs 154 pounds and is 23 years old. She has always been known, Don, for her thigh development. She has really fantastic thighs, and the definition and the size of her thighs are really well known. Here you see a shot of her thighs. The problem that she has always had, especially at the pre-judging, is when she was compared to other bodybuilders, it was her deltoids. Her shoulders were a little bit underdeveloped. And I think even today, I see the same problem. She does not have the definition and the deltoids that she should have in order to be up there in the top.
Katie Rubas of Budapest, Hungary. A lot of the competitors that we've seen, Arnold, began as part of proving themselves in other areas of athletic competition, track and field or gymnastics. Katie, who we're watching, actually began because she had a weight problem and wanted to reduce body fat. She's sure done that.
She's really great, and she's made great progress. Here you can see the V-shaped body that I was talking about. Wide shoulders, small waist, she has tremendous latissimus muscles. Her back is really well developed.
Now we come to Kimberly Chizevsky. This is a young lady who came in first here 2 years ago, winning the Ms. International in 93. I remember how thrilled she was that night, Arnold. She hadn't been competing that long, and she came up with a major championship.
That's right. And you know something? She's back, and she's better than ever. Look at her intercostals. Look at her abdominals, the definition of the whole body, the lower back, upper back. Look at the leg biceps she's displaying and the calves. She's really spectacular. And of course, her posing fits exactly her body. So she has a good chance, the way I saw it early on in the pre-judging, she has a good chance of winning again. Look at her development in the back, the latissimus muscle.
Actually, she began training when her future husband spotted her teaching aerobics. He was a bodybuilder and convinced Kimberly that she had great potential. And that certainly played out.
That's right. She's been training for 6 years now. Now she's 5'8 tall and she weighs 160 pounds, which she doesn't look like it. I mean, look at the definition of her thighs. I mean, to weigh 160 pounds and have almost no body fat, it's spectacular. I mean, the amount of training that she has put into this body is tremendous.
She actually trains twice a day for an hour and a half each time.
When you watch her performance, you can see that there's really no weak point in her body. I mean, every part is equally developed, and this is what makes one score very high in a bodybuilding competition. Amongst men and women, is the proportion, that the one body part is not overdeveloped compared to another. Look at the bicep development and the separation of the deltoids.
How many judges, Arnold, are looking at this now?
There's nine judges that are looking at this, and the highest score and the lowest score is being thrown out. And so it's an international judging panel that no one knows ahead of time, you know, who is judging. It's always decided on a day before. There's a drawing, and then they decide. Look at her routine. I think that she's going to get a great ovation, which is going to have some impact also on the judges. Look at that. She does it really the best.
She's been a champion right here at this event in 1993. Kimberly Chizevsky from Springfield, Missouri. Oh, she did. Yeah.
Look at the V-shaped body, the definition, the bicep development, the latissimus, the whole thing. She can be proud of her performance.
A lot of grace and style in the way
now
she
look
presents
at this.
Herself.
Here you can see the proportion that she has. Perfect thigh development, calf development, small waist. I mean, here in this pose, she shows it all. It's really fantastic.
He started.
And we'll be back to the 1995 Miss International competition from Columbus, Ohio in a moment.
Yeah.
Good job.
Great. Thank you.
The one-stop shopping package, they can find out all about the diet, the exercise regimen.
Besides the competitions, the Arnold Schwarzenegger Fitness Weekend also features an expo.
Stay in that crunch position.
Here, 25,000 people swarm over 300 booths and displays featuring the latest supplements, clothing, and personalities in the sports of bodybuilding and fitness.
This is a Skywalker. It's a non-impact upper and lower body resistance machine. This is called the Star Trek 1200. It's a light commercial treadmill, very similar to the club treadmills that we have.
So these are my new posters back here. Boots and glutes. It's R.
The expo here is great for getting mobbed.
So that's why in the endurance formula we've got MCTs, of course, more expensive.
So it virtually works all the muscles from your waist to your knees without putting a lot of pressure here.
Big, very big, very big.
You got any family on your hands?
So
be talking.
The Arnold Fitness Expo is one of the largest health and fitness expos in the world.
And we welcome you back to the 1995 Miss International Competition here in Columbus, Ohio. From London, England, now training out of Venice, California, this is Joanne Lee. 26 years old.
You know how much she weighs? She weighs 175 pounds. And you would never guess when you watch her pose.
Never would. 5 feet, 8 inches tall, 175.
She's only been a professional now for 1 year, but she has been competing for 9 years and training for 10 years.
She was a track athlete in her native England, began the strength training to get better and liked bodybuilding better and gave up track and field. Now she's a world-class bodybuilder. An international lady. She is born in England, has lived in Australia, now living in Venice, California.
England, of course, has produced some tremendous bodybuilders. You know, I remember when I used to compete, the men were just fantastic. There were a lot of British bodybuilders that became Mr. Universe. And I think you see the same thing now amongst the women. The women are really getting better and better all the time and really creating tough competition for the American women.
Didn't you and your good friend, another former world champion, Franco Colombo, used to train in London?
Yes, we trained in London. We trained all over the world, but London was one of those places that we went quite frequently and did demonstrations and seminars and did a lot of powerlifting, strongman acts in England and all those things. I think that what I've seen, again, at the pre-judging, what I see right now, she has a good chance to be in the top five or six tonight.
Joanne Lee. She was the overall British champion back in 91, and recently did very well in the Canadian Pro Cup competition, finishing fifth.
She needs a little bit more back. Her back is not as defined as some of the other bodybuilders. But if she would straighten out the back and get it more defined, I think she has a good chance of winning because she really has a lot of things going for herself. Fantastic thighs. Terrific. Very good routine, I have to say.
And very well received here at Veterans Memorial Auditorium in Columbus.
Yeah, she has a terrific personality and she's does this whole routine in a very sexy way, so I think this is her thing.
One of the best things about Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, more stuff.
The next competitor, Michelle Andrea, 26 years old from Tallahassee, Florida. She's the co-owner of a health club in Tallahassee with 4,600 members. So she's turned bodybuilding into more than a sport. It's also a big business.
She's 5'5 tall and she weighs 143 pounds. And she has been training for 6.5 years now and competing for 4 years. Now here's another one that she does not look as heavy as she is. And I think the reason is because they have so little body fat. I mean, most of those women have less than 8% body fat. And muscle, of course, weighs five times as much as fat. And this is why none of those women look as heavy as they really are.
That is very interesting.
Yeah.
There's not much fat in a competition like this. It's all muscle. It is pretty remarkable. She's a great proponent, Arnold, of the psychological approach. She said she won't even talk out loud about any body part she thinks needs more development because it'll keep that part lagging behind. You might hear her.
That's right. Look at the calf development. She really has tremendous calves, great leg bicep, quadriceps. The whole lower part of the body is really well developed. I think that if she gets her arms as well developed and her latissimus muscle, I think she has a good chance of being in the top three someday. I don't think she will make it this time. But she's a very attractive woman, I have to say, and she handles herself really well.
Michelle Andrea from Tallahassee, Florida.
Very good performance. Yes. Oh, that after shot. That's one of the tricks that a lot of bodybuilders use, you know.
Our next contestant. You're looking now at one of the most popular performers here and one of the most successful, a two-time Miss International champion. She won this event in 1990 and 1994. Laura Crivell from Orchard Beach, Maine.
In the sport of bodybuilding, the metaphor of the tortoise and the hare is an apt description of the two types of competitors. One, the hare, races toward success at breakneck speed, only to burn out before reaching fulfillment. The other, the tortoise, makes slow and steady improvements, gradually working toward a consistent reign at the top of their field. Laura Crivell embodies this spirit of tenacious effort. Originally from the nation of Guyana in South America, she emigrated to Venice Beach in the mid-1980s to pursue a career as a bodybuilder. As the years went by, she became a top amateur, then a professional. Her greatest successes, however, came when she relocated to the rustic state of Maine.
It's a lot easier since I've moved to Maine to train because I haven't got the stress of all my competitors in LA. And also, it's very quiet and very relaxed lifestyle I have. I live right on the beach. I get up in the morning and this horse is running on the beach. And if I'm not happy there and at peace with myself and enjoy my training, I can't be happy anywhere in the world. So I think it's made a difference in how I look physically and how I feel mentally.
Over time, a controversy arose in women's bodybuilding. What was too much muscle for a woman? Had the line already been crossed? Unwillingly, Laura found herself entrenched in this debate. But for someone who had devoted over a decade to building her body through diligent training and diet, the answer was clear.
We're told that they're not looking for a Miss Fitness, they are looking for an athletic female physique. So if that's what they're looking for, I like those criteria. I don't think they've changed. They haven't really changed from what they were. I think they got a little scared there and it went one extreme to the other, but I think it's going to come back to the middle of the road.
In Maine with husband Chris Aceto, Laura's life has become more stable. She has branched off into business ventures with a clothing line, training videos, and her own bodybuilding camp. After two wins at the Ms. International and three runner-up showings at the Ms. Olympia, Laura Crivell has firmly established herself as one of the best competitors that the sport of women's bodybuilding has ever seen.
Two-time Ms. International champion, Laura Crivell.
You can see that her rear deltoids, the latissimus, the trapezius, the lower back, everything is really chiseled and well-developed. Look at the leg bicep. See, that's where you show perfection when you show poses like that. She, at one given time, shows to the judges that my back is well-developed, my thighs, my calves, my biceps, everything is developed. She really moves around well and shows that. You know, she's 5'4 tall and she weighs 151 pounds. She's 36 years old. She's been training now for 14 years. Okay. her posing is right on the money. I think she's doing a terrific job. And I have seen her earlier today. I've seen her in a pump-up room where she was pumping up. And I have to tell you that I think she has a great chance of winning. But, of course, I'm not a judge, so I don't know. But, I mean, I tell you, she really has a good shot at it.
She's very matter-of-fact. She said she began in this sport to increase her self-esteem, and now she's a major champion.
Yes. She also knows how to please the audience. You can see that some of the poses are for the audience. Some of the moves that she just has done and she's doing right now is for the audience. And then there's certain shots again and certain poses that she does, which is directed for the judges.
And her final pose coming up.
Look at her smile, making it look like all comfortable and confident.
Two-time Miss International champion, Laura Crevel. She's the defending champion.
This is the back pose where you can see exactly what I was talking about. Great rear deltoid development, great side lateral, side deltoid development, trapezius, the whole back is there. I think she's one of the best back muscles of any of the competitors.
And that's why she won this event in 1990 and 1994.
Did Audrey see me?
The 1995 Miss International competition continues from Columbus in a moment.
Did it look like I screwed up?
No. Welcome back to the Miss International competition in Columbus, Ohio. And here is another very formidable competitor, Yvonne Vasquez from Coral Springs, Florida. She was the heavyweight national champion in 1993.
She has a tremendous performance, great thigh development, as you can see here again, and very little that I can see that she has weak points. She has almost no weak points, and that's why I think that she will place very high.
This is Yvonne Vasquez from Coral Springs, Florida, originally from Miami. Her day job is a personal trainer. She helps other people become proficient at bodybuilding and getting in better shape. And
beautiful routine, very well done. Here you can see in this photograph what a great thigh development she has, wonderful calves. I mean, she really has the most outstanding thighs and calves of any of the competitors.
Now, from Germany, Diana Gimler. She was a world amateur champion in 1991. She's the reigning German champion. And this is her first Miss International competition, something she says she's dreamed of competing in ever since she first knew Arnold Schwarzenegger was associated with it.
Now she's 5 feet four tall and weighs 135 pounds, and she's 30 years old. She's been training for quite some time, but I mean, she trains five times a week. 1.5 hours each time. She did a good job.
Diana Gimler, 30 years old.
And here you can show, see the separation and the small waist and good proportions.
Next up.
And here is one of the superstars in women's bodybuilding, Debbie Mugley, who has just an array of championships during her career. Very, very popular here in Columbus at the Miss International competition.
She's very popular, you're right. And she, of course, looks great. She came in good shape. She's 5'5 tall, weighs 153 pounds, is 31 years old, and she's Fantastic. Yes, she's finishing off the right way. I think she's going to score really high. Really well done.
31-year-old Debbie Mugley, former North American champion.
Here you can see the separation of her back, her latissimus muscles, her arms. It's really, she's in great shape.
And we'll be back to the 1995 Miss International competition in a moment.
How? Yeah.
Welcome back to the 1995 Miss International competition. An event founded by the gentleman I'm pleased to work with again this year, Arnold Schwarzenegger, so many times a Mr. Universe, the most acclaimed world bodybuilder in the history of the sport. And right now is a young lady who is another top competitor among the women, Nikki Fuller from Portland, Oregon. 29 years old, weighs 170 pounds, believe it or not.
Yes, she weighs 170 pounds, and she is definitely one of the heaviest women in this competition. And carries the weight very well, has very little body fat. Her posing is great. She really stood out this afternoon at the pre-judging. Her best body parts are chest and arms. She's known for that. You can see here the arms. Really fantastic arm development. Let's see when she turns around and she shows the chest. There you see the separation of the pectoral muscles. Great abdominals also.
Nikki Fuller from Portland, Oregon. She said, Arnold, she really got into the sport because she wanted to stand out on a crowded beach. She'll do that. She stands out among the best women bodybuilders in the world.
Wow, look at that split. Ow, that hurts me. Wow. Really great posing. Look at this. Important that you know what you're doing here. Great finishing off, crowd pleaser, judge pleaser, everything.
Nikki Fuller from Portland, Oregon.
Fantastic abdominals. She really has great abdominals and great chest muscles. You can see it in this photo here, in this shot.
We come to our next competitor, Audrey Harris White, 41 years old, getting better all the time, and she is a 10-year veteran of the Orlando, Florida Police Department. She's married to a man who's also into strength training. Bodybuilding.
It's bad having her as a training partner, huh? What do you think?
She's excellent.
See how she looks always. She has a great facial expression. Beautiful. Great finishing off touch. I think she's going to do really well.
The oldest competitor in this event and one of the very best, Audrey Harris White, 41 years old.
Here you can see a tremendous chest development, fantastic deltoid development, good separation between arms and deltoids. Great physique.
We'll return for the selection of the top six competitors of the Miss International competition after this. Welcome back to the 1995 Miss International competition, and our champion will come from one of these six women. as they're in the pose down, the critical and deciding area from which the champion will be selected. And who better to judge from afar than Arnold Schwarzenegger, not one of the nine judges, but one of the world's renowned experts on this. Who looks good to you here, Arnold?
Well, Don, I tell you, first of all, this is a very important round because, again, here you can lose or win the competition. And I think that number nine, Laura Gravel, is one that stands out to me during the pose-off. She stood out to me in the afternoon at the pre-judging. And I think she really has a good shot to win this competition again. And, of course, also Debbie Mugley is outstanding. She's really doing well because you see what happens here is you have to pose and hit the right pose at the right time next to the right person because you want to show to the judges that your biceps are bigger and better defined than your competitors. You want to show that if someone does a lat spread that your lat spread is better, that your double bicep pose is better, that your abdominals are better. You want to show, and this is why you have to be very quick in your thinking and deciding on which pose you should do at what time.
Competition really heats up here in the pose down. It, in a way, becomes kind of a free-form posing. I mean, you show the best you have. And
yeah, Nikki Fuller is also very, very good. She's the number 13. She's very, very good and very quick in reacting to the various different poses. So I think it's over now. And
it's up to nine judges to make their decision.
And the judges could call them out again if they're not, if there's a split decision of some sort. You know,
And there is the panel of nine judges.
Yes.
Who will determine the winner of the 1995 Miss International Competition. We'll be back to find out who the winner is after this.
Ladies, I'd like to say one thing.
As female bodybuilding's counterpart to the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic, the Miss International is a major event in the sport of women's professional bodybuilding. The first champion in 1989 was Tanya Knight, bodybuilding's golden girl. This blonde bombshell also made her mark as the American Gladiator Gold. 1990 saw Laura Crevel win her first professional title at the Miss International. Originally from the nation of Guyana in South America, she would soon become a constant threat at the Miss Olympia event. In 1991, Tanya Knight returned to competition after 2 years away from the stage and triumphed in Columbus for a second time. This would prove to be her shining moment in competition. Judging standards took a different turn in 1992 as the sleek Anya Schreiner set the pace for the new look in women's bodybuilding. Her lean lines were a brief testament to a changing climate in the sport. Kim Chizevsky did the near impossible by winning her first professional contest at the 1993 Miss International. The 23-year-old from Decatur, Illinois, showed that youth and inexperience couldn't stop a physique whose time had come. Laura Crevel claimed the Miss International title in 1994 and became the second woman to hold the title twice. Though she has had difficulty winning the elusive Miss Olympia title, it seems as if she might just keep winning the Miss International. Once again, the best female bodybuilders from around the world have gathered to compete here at the Miss International in Columbus, Ohio.
Welcome back to the 1995 Miss International Competition, and here are the six finalists. Having completed the pose down, Arnold Schwarzenegger has left our broadcast position. He is out to present the champion's award when she is announced.
Chip Snyder of marketing success. Goes to contestant number 13, Nikki Fuller.
There is the number six finisher, Nikki Fuller. And the boos are because I think some of the competitors feel she should have placed higher. Young lady from Portland, Oregon, has really been rising in this sport.
All right, Nikki. Good job.
Nikki Fuller, number six.
Fourth runner-up award, $2,000. Presented by George Fullman of Signal American Marketing. Contestant number seven, Joanna Lee.
Joanne Lee is the fourth runner-up. And now we'll see who is the fourth finisher in this overall competition.
Third runner up. Gets a trophy and a check for $3,000. That will be presented by Mr. Richard Brizzaro of Weir.
The suspense build is
to competitor number 14, Audrey Harris White.
Audrey Harris White. A $3,000 prize. She finished fourth overall and holds the ranking of the third overall runner-up. There are three remaining. To the left is a former champion, Kim Chavesky. To the right is a two-time champion, Laura Crivell. And in the middle is Debbie Mugley, who's not won this event yet. Debbie Mugley, and a $6,000 check to Debbie. So again, she comes close, but does not go home with the Ms. International champion. We now come down to the deciding moment of this 1995 Ms. International competition. Two former champions vying for the title. On the left is Kim Chavesky. She won in 1993. And on the right, Laura Crivell, a two-time champion. She won it last year and in 1990.
A trophy and a check for $10,000, presented by Adair Fritz of Hummer. That goes to contestant number six, Kim Chavesky.
Kim Chavesky is the second place finisher, and with it goes a $10,000 check. And for a third time, Laura Crivell will win the Ms. International competition here at Columbus, Ohio, from Orchard Beach, Maine. The defending champion wins again for a third time. And we'll be back in a moment. And we welcome you back to the 1995 Miss International competition here in Columbus, Ohio. And here comes Arnold Schwarzenegger with the championship trophy. There they are, the champion and the founder of the event, Arnold Schwarzenegger. We'll be back as Arnold introduces us with an interview to Laura Crivell, the 95 Ms. International champion. We'll be back in a moment. And welcome back to the 1995 Ms. International competition. And there's our champion, a champion for a third time, Laura Crivell, and she's with Arnold Schwarzenegger right now.
Thank you, Don. I'm here with the winner. Congratulations, you look fantastic. How does it feel now winning three competitions like this, the three Miss International in a row?
It feels fantastic, scary. It gets scarier every year, but it feels wonderful.
Now, you looked to me perfect the last time you won. What did you do in order to improve?
I try to bring up my weak points. My legs were good, but my arms were a little weak, so I worked in that for the year.
When you train every day and you do the dieting, how much is diet and how much is the training?
I think I'd say 50-50. If you train hard and you don't diet as hard, then you end up having a good physique but not low body fat, so you can go from first to 10th place. So you want to have the whole package, so I'd say 50-50.
And how important is posing in the whole performance?
Posing, it's important because you have to show what you have when you get out there. And you show your personality, that's when your personality really comes in.
Well, Laura, congratulations. You had great posing, great dieting, great training. Everything was great. Come back to the Miss International, okay?
And that concludes the 1995 Miss International competition. For Arnold Schwarzenegger, this is Don Cricky. Glad you could be with us, and we'll look for you next year.
Hotel accommodations in Columbus have been provided by the Holiday Inn on the Lane. You'll realize the moment you check in at the Inn on the Lane that you've made the right choice. It's what you deserve. Custom video services provided by Cinema Concepts of Columbus. Innovative solutions for commercial and home theater.